He was only supposed to make sure I got home okay. But instead, he's my cousin. He's family. He was supposed to protect me. I only go to visit once every few years. He asked me if I had a boyfriend. I didn't say anything. He told me I grew up nicely into a woman. That made me feel dirty. But I am a good girl, and just because I'm American, it doesn't make me easy or a slut. But he stood in front of me and started touching me, and not in a way a family member is supposed to. And then he pushed me against the wall and changed me forever. I don't think I'll ever visit again. I wanted to tell my mom, my dad, but when I told my roommate, she said, okay, so common, there's nothing you can do. Can this be right? This can't be right!
Thank you.
Dr. Sita, I'm queer and I'm proud to say that. And I want to be proud of my culture, but I just don't know how to tell my parents. And my girlfriend is not helping.
I took world religions. In Hinduism, Shiva's known to be both male and female at the same time. Your family can accept this, but they can't accept you?
I'm in love with her. But now, every time we fight, she threatens to out me.
I accept you as you are. Your family doesn't. What if I tell your mother I'm not your best friend?
I'm embarrassed this is happening. How do I tell my parents before she does?
No one should talk to you this way.
It took a lot of courage for you to come in today. Draw strength and pride from that. Use that.
We'll meet again next week. There's no difference in the level of pain or trauma based on sexual preference or gender identity.
Dr. Sita, thank you so much for agreeing to this interview. If you don't mind, I just have one more question.
Sure.
All right. In your years of study, what has surprised you the most?
On my website, message boards. People write in to share their stories all the time. My years of study have illustrated that this problem escapes no one. No community is immune. One story of a man who in many ways would be my exact opposite shared the painfully familiar story of abuse.
Dr. Sita, I know you work primarily with women, but I can't ignore the parallels between the stories I read on your website and my own. I'm tall, 6'2".
I'm a white gay man. I never thought abuse was something that could happen to me. I never called it abuse. I called it earthquakes.
Last Christmas Day, there was an earthquake. There were tremors in the past, nothing new, but this was a record 9.0, a knife to my throat. I screamed silently, but no one heard.
The earth has split in two. Split us in two. Into the night I ran, seeing Christmas lights strung on a line. 10 years of history we shared. Christmas lights. Tiny moments of beautiful light that flash brilliant and bright.
Strung together as I was strung alone through moments of darkness. Camouflaged to hide the ugly earthquakes, hidden from sight.
The drinking, the ranting, the jealousy, the anger. They were all tremors that led to the last Christmas Day.
Like Mary, Joseph, and unborn baby Jesus, I am seeking shelter, but there are no rooms at the inn. Skid Row shelter, where men looked at me like prey and used alcohol. It's not safe for someone like you. The women's shelter could not accept me for months. My car was my refuge.
Away from you, away from your earthquakes, the Christmas lights begin to shine with light and hope.
This Christmas, I celebrate the earthquake that broke us apart.
I shine.